Hey, what's up everyone, this is Bro Smart, and in this video I'm going to compare the Zenfone Max Pro M2 with the Redmi Note 7. For this video I'm going to use the Zenfone Max Pro M2 3GB variant and the Redmi Note 7 4GB variant. So yeah, the RAM is not the same, it is 4GB and 3GB, but still I don't think 1GB RAM will matter that. So let's review these two phones and let's get started. These two phones have Snapdragon 66 and the graphics is also the same, which is Adreno 512. In terms of performance, both these phones are really good. I mean, I play PUBG regularly on the Zenfone Max Pro M2 and damn, it is a great. And the PUBG performance is really good. I mean, I didn't see any lags or hitting issues or nothing. Same will be for the Redmi Note 7. I played PUBG on it and yeah, the performance was really good. There were no lags, there were no, you know, jittering or frame drops. And the gaming performance on the Redmi Note 7 was also very good when I played PUBG and other games like Critical Ops. I mean, some people lean towards Redmi because of the customer service, timely updates. Talking about updates and customer service, Asus took a long time to send the Pi up. And even I am using the Zenfone Max Pro M2 now, and the Pi update is still incomplete. There is no notch customize option. So if you care about customer service, timely updates and all, I would recommend the Redmi Note 7. But in general, if you only talk about the gaming performance and all, I would recommend the Zenfone Max Pro M2 only for gaming, nothing all. Because I play PUBG and Critical Ops like 3 to 4 hours a day. And yeah, so I can tell you that Zenfone Max Pro M2 is the phone for game. Talking about the phone's design, the Redmi Note 7 has a glass back with Gorilla Glass 5 protection and the Zenfone Max Pro M2 has a plastic back. So in terms of feel and looks, I would definitely recommend the Redmi Note 7 because it has a really good looking glass back. And if you are purchasing a Redmi Note 7, then go for the blue color because it looks damn amazing. Coming to Zenfone Max Pro M2, it has a plastic back and yeah, there will be a lot of scratches and fingerprints on the phone's back. And yeah, always use the plastic cover if you are using the Zenfone Max Pro M2. Otherwise, you will see a lot of scratches and fingerprints on the phone's back. So, starting the comparison video with the boot test. Switching these two phones together, as you can see, the logo animation of the Redmi Note 7 appears first and then the Zenfone Max Pro. So here in this case, as you can see, the Zenfone Max Pro M2 takes a long time to switch on. Next is app opening time. So let's start this comparison with the Instagram app. So as you can see, Instagram opened much faster in the Redmi Note 7. It is because of the 4GB RAM, but anyways, the Redmi Note 7 is a lot faster than the Zenfone Max Pro M2 when it comes to Instagram. Going to YouTube, as you can see, the YouTube opens much faster again in the Redmi Note 7, has 4GB RAM, opens YouTube faster. Talking about Netflix, the Netflix app tends to open faster on the Zenfone Max Pro M2, though I don't have an extra account on the Redmi Note 7, but still, Netflix opens faster on the Zenfone Max Pro M2. Now, this is my favorite game, which is Critical Ops. Let's see who is the winner. As you can see, the Redmi Note 7 clearly wins on the first round because the animation logo starts first on the Redmi Note 7. So the game opening time in the Redmi Note 7 is much faster than the Zenfone Max Pro M2. Now it is time for the king of all Android games, which is PUBG Mobile. As you saw, the PUBG Mobile starts much faster and loads much faster than the Zenfone Max Pro M2 in the Redmi Note 7. Okay, so after all the comparison, speed test, here is the photography and videography comparison. First of all, these two phones have stellar cameras. I mean, the camera module on the Redmi Note 7 is better than the Zenfone Max Pro M2, though it runs on stock Android, but I didn't find the camera app on the Zenfone Max Pro M2 that interesting because the camera app is too simple and there are very, very less options in the Zenfone Max Pro M2's camera. Even there is no time lapse option. In terms of the selfie, I would say that the Zenfone Max Pro M2 did a pretty good job because as you can see, the blacks look really good. I mean, the saturation, the white balance and the exposure are really great on the Zenfone Max Pro M2. Now let's take a look at the Redmi Note 7. As you can see, the photo is overexposed. The blacks are not even black, it is grayish and the sky is overexposed and the brightness is not accurate. And overall, I don't think it is a great selfie. So obviously, I will choose the Zenfone Max Pro M2 if I want to take amazing selfies. Now, videos are also the same. As you can see, here is the side-by-side comparison video of the Redmi Note 7 and the Zenfone Max Pro M2. Take a look. Okay, so this is a side-by-side comparison between the
on Redmi Note 7's front camera and the Zenfone Max Pro M2's front camera. So here are the results. I feel that the Zenfone Max Pro M2 is doing a good job in the front camera department because my face, my color is accurate, but in the Xiaomi Redmi Note 7, the colors are not that saturated. It is white and yeah, the beauty mode is really bad on the Note 7.
Now coming to the back camera or the rear camera, these two phones are really good at it. I mean, I feel that the photo quality of the Redmi Note 7 is better than the Zenfone Max Pro M2. Take a look at the Redmi Note 7's camera. You are getting all the options like the slow motion, square photo mode, time lapse, manual mode, and a ton more options. But if you take a look at the Zenfone Max Pro M2's camera mode, there are very few and less options. So yeah, definitely if you are a photo geek, if you love to take photos with the rear camera, then I will definitely recommend the Note 7. For camera, again, I would recommend the Redmi Note 7. Honestly, I am using the Zenfone Max Pro M2 and this is my daily phone. I take selfies and photos with the Zenfone Max Pro M2. The Redmi Note 7 I use for the review and for this video is of my friends. So yeah, if I had that phone with me like all the time, if I purchased that phone, I would obviously use the Redmi Note 7 to take pictures and that would be my main phone. Talking about the Redmi Note 7, the photos look really good. Even, not even the photo, the videos also looks really dope. I mean, you were getting 4K and also electronic video stabilization with the Redmi Note 7, and yeah, it is a really good thing. Now the thing I really liked about Redmi Note 7 is the slow motion video feature. You can shoot videos at 120fps at 1080p. So yeah, 1080p videos at 120fps, just imagine. I know competitors like the Realme 3 Pro has 960fps slow motion mode, but keeping the price under 10,000 rupees, if you are planning to shoot slow motion videos under 10,000 rupees, I would definitely recommend the Note 7 because it has a really good camera. So in terms of camera, I would definitely go for the Redmi Note 7. And yeah, Zenfone Max Pro M2, I don't know what Asus is doing. They are not providing updates and also Redmi Note 7 is the winner. If you enjoyed watching this video, then smash the like button and also subscribe to Bro Smart for more interesting videos, comparison videos, photography videos and review videos just like this one. So as always, thank you so much for watching. This is Bro Smart and I will see you guys in my next video.